Hey everyone, my name is Adrienne Finch, and in today's video, I'm showing you step-by-step how to build a beautiful website for free using Canva. It's no secret that over the last few years, a lot of things have switched to being online, like stores and classes and meetings. And though it may be overwhelming, the good news is that it is possible to create, do, or sell just about anything online with zero experience needed. That's why I'm here. If you're new here, I've created a ton of tutorial videos that'll help you start and scale your online business quickly and efficiently. So feel free to check out these playlists on my channel, and I'll link them in the description box as well. So if you're not familiar with Canva, it's a free to use online graphic design tool. They have thousands of templates to choose from that allow you to create social media posts, presentations, posters, videos, logos, and yes, even websites, quickly and easily with no knowledge or experience. Though Canva is free, there is a pro subscription that's available for purchase that unlocks their full suite of graphics and functions, which you can notice are marked with this crown icon. I recently upgraded to Canva Pro myself, but it's not necessary in my opinion because what's available to you on the free version is more than enough. Now, there are two website formats we can work with in Canva, and I'm gonna show you both. First, we have a traditional landscape format that uses AI to ensure the site functions across desktop and mobile devices. This is the most versatile option for sure, but does come with a caveat that I'll discuss later. Or second, a mobile-only vertical site perfect for social media bio links or other just simple landing pages. This page can still be accessed on desktop, the dimensions will just remain locked. All right, so now it's time to dive into Canva and show you how to make a beautiful website in just a few minutes. So to begin, you wanna go to canva.com and make a free account. Alternatively, you could go to this website, which I'll link below, that kind of walks you through it and helps show you some of the things I'll be talking about. So what you're gonna wanna do first is go ahead and click on websites right here, and then scroll down to browse all the templates that they have. I love that they break them up by category. There are literally so many to choose from. You've got plain websites, business, portfolio, event websites. And if you aren't seeing anything you like, feel free to use the search bar to type exactly what you're looking for. For example, if I type in podcast website, you'll see both mobile sites and regular sites here. Feel free to check the websites box on the side right here, and it'll go ahead and only show you the landscape format website pages. You can star your favorites to come back to later, or you can click the three dots and actually preview this template before you go ahead and start editing it. If you like what you see, just click customize this template, or just click on the template on the original page, and it'll go ahead and open up the editor. You'll notice when scrolling that some templates have more than one page, like this one, and others will just be one page, like the one we chose. If you want to add more pages to your site, you can always click layouts up here, and it'll show you a bunch of options for other pages you can include that have the same look and feel and branding of the template you chose. You can also mix and match templates by clicking add page and then choosing a different page from any template to add. And there you go. All right, so now that you've chosen a template, let's start to build the site. Something that's important to remember is you always want to be thinking mobile first. Meaning, even though we're making edits to this page right here, you want to be frequently checking how everything appears on mobile. And you can do that by clicking on this preview button up here, making sure this box is checked that says resize on mobile, and then click on this mobile device right here. If everything looks like it's formatted correctly and totally works on mobile, then you're good to go. The reason it's important to build your site with mobile in mind first is because almost 50% of website traffic occurs on mobile devices. So you wanna make sure that everything functions and runs smoothly and looks good so that you're not missing out on sales and things like that because your website's clunky. Like I said before, Canva AI will actually do the work of resizing the site to mobile for you. But the caveat that I was talking about earlier is that if something doesn't look right on mobile, it's pretty hard to adjust it in a way that successfully fixes the issue. On other website builders like Wix, you can actually edit the mobile site manually without affecting how it appears on desktop, but unfortunately, not here. You can notice that this feature is in beta, so that's probably why. My best workaround so that you're not facing this issue very often is to first and foremost arrange the pages and the elements where you want them, make sure it all functions well on mobile, and then go in and customize everything to include your photos, your text, your colors, all of that. That way you don't do all this work only for it to kind of not work out on mobile. Also, if you do end up previewing it on mobile and it doesn't look very good, you can try moving around these elements and see if you can get them to line up where they should be on mobile. Alternatively, you can skip the landscape format altogether and build your site vertically if you know that most of your traffic's coming from mobile or you just want a simple bio link landing page or something like that, like I mentioned earlier. And I'll show you how to do this a little later in the video. Okay, now it's time to show you how the editor works and how to customize your site the way you want it. All right, so first and foremost, I always like to go up to the top here and just rename the site so it's something I can easily find and come back to later. Now, to begin customizing, it's important to know you can click pretty much anywhere on the page to edit. By highlighting text, you're able to choose from any number of fonts, colors, text effects that are extremely customizable. And elements are able to be changed in terms of the colors. Sometimes you'll click on an element and it'll kind of show you this dotted outline at the top. That means that both this white background button and this text have been grouped together. So if you move it around, it'll move as a group. If you want to ungroup this, just highlight it and select ungroup. Now you can separately move the text and the background. Click this button if you want to duplicate a page. And this button if you want to delete a page. And now let me walk you through the menu on the left-hand side. So this design tab that we're on right now, this is where you can see all the templates, add other pages, change the style, and more. Layouts, I already mentioned, are just other options for pages that you can add that are matching the same branding as the template you chose. Under styles, they have grouped together certain color schemes and fonts that you can actually just select and change the entire look of the whole thing. If you click on the elements tab right here, this is where you can add elements like buttons, designs, icons, photos, stickers, charts, or you can browse from various collections that they have. You can search for just about anything you want in here. Podcast logo. And things will pop up in different categories. Simply click on an icon if you want it, and then you'll notice up here, you can change the colors of the icon, which is really cool. Resize it like this and pretty much move it wherever you want. Let's delete this one and put this right here. Now, if you click on uploads, you're actually able to upload your own photos and videos and graphics, and it'll keep a library of everything that you've uploaded right here for easy access, which is really nice. Now, let's pretend that I want to use this image for something. You can click on edit image and again, have access to a lot of editing tools, and they have other interesting kind of mock-ups and things you can use as well. That's creepy, but pretty cool. If you do have the pro version, there is a background remover tool, which would not work very well on this photo, but let me just choose something else to show you really quick. This is one of the best tools I've seen. It is actually so accurate and easy to do. I have so much trouble doing it on Photoshop, but here it's so easy. But look at how good that was. Pretty crazy. Another cool way to insert a photo is if you go back to elements and click on frame or search frames, anything with this little image in it is a frame. This is really neat because they have different types of mock-ups like books and laptops and things like that that just make it really easy instead of having to size your own image. You just drag and drop and it'll do it for you. Double click to move it around, boom. Now, the text tab, this offers a bunch of different font combinations and kind of graphic text ideas, or you can simply click to add a heading, subheading, or body text, type whatever you need, and change the font and color as so. The projects tab just shows you all of the open projects you have. I rarely ever click on it from here. Photos is if you need to use any stock photos for your things. They actually have so many available for free, which is very nice. And then we have the background tab. Just click on the background to change the color, or on the background tab, you can choose from any photo or pattern or gradient or color. So as you can see, you can literally just search whatever you want or browse what they have. As with everything else, you can edit the image however you need. Ooh, I like these. This is very busy, but I think I'm gonna stick with that one for now. So now that you know how to customize it, let's build the actual site. Obviously, there are some things that I need to change here. We're gonna make that blue so it sticks out a little more. We need to, of course, change this to my name. I'm actually gonna switch the frame here. I think I want it to be a laptop. You can use this position key to bring an element forward or backwards. We're gonna add this photo. And then just remember to be checking periodically the preview of the mobile site so that you know that it still functions and looks good. That looks great. I already really love these buttons, so I'm gonna keep them and just write out what I would want. There we go. But if you wanted to add any other buttons, you would just go back up to Elements, click on this Buttons tab, or just use any of the other shapes that are right here and adjust them however you want. Now, how do you actually get these buttons to be clickable? So, if you highlight the element and click on the three dots right here, you'll see this button that says Link. From there, just type or search the link that you want this button to go to. So for me, it'll be my YouTube channel. Push Enter, and the link will be added. Now, again, if you have text and a button, I recommend clicking on the top layer, holding the Shift button and clicking on the back layer, that'll select both, and click on Group. Then use the three dots and actually add the link to that. That way, if they accidentally click the text but not the back part, it'll still take them to the link. These are already grouped, as you'll notice, so the three dots aren't there, but up here you can see this link button. Click on that and just do the same thing. Once you add your hyperlinks, you're gonna wanna go to preview again and just test that it's actually clickable. So there we go. I clicked and it actually took us to my YouTube channel. You can link any element, whether it be a social media icon, a button, text, anything. So play around with that and really use this to your advantage. If you're selling a product or you have a sales page or a store page, but you just wanted one clean landing page, you can create a button that says buy now and link your sales page. If you don't already have a store or a way to accept payments for products, check out my video on how to build an online store with Wix. Wix is my favorite option when it comes to online stores, but it does cost money. But there are tons of other free apps that allow you to sell products too, like Payhip. So I'll do a video on those if you guys want at some point. Congrats on making it this far. Now that your page is the way that you like it, the links work, you've tested it on mobile, it is time to actually publish your site. So as you can imagine, you're just gonna go up to this button that says Publish Website.
So the first thing it'll ask you is whether you want to resize on mobile, and I would just check yes. And then it'll ask you if you want to have no navigation or you want to have navigation. I'm gonna select without navigation, but if you have multiple pages on your site and you want navigation, let me show you how to do that. So you're gonna wanna close out of publishing actually, and what you need to do in order for navigation to work is name your pages. There are a couple ways to do this. You can either click on this Add Notes button right here, you can click right here, or you can click down here to actually show the grid view of each of your pages and literally just click on this pencil right here to name your page. You would just type it in, boom. Click this again, I'll just show you how to do it here. Same thing. So on page two, I might write podcast. Now your pages are named, so if you go to preview, you should actually be able to see this navigation up at the top, which you can just click on and it'll take you to each of the pages. On mobile, it's the same thing, and there you go.
And then it'll give you the option here to either publish to a free domain, which will be a Canva domain, purchase a new domain through Canva, or use an existing domain that you already own. Personally, I do not recommend buying one through Canva. If you're gonna buy a domain, I suggest GoDaddy or Google Domains. You buy it over there, and then you would click on use my existing domain. If you're not sure yet or you don't have a domain, just publish it to the free Canva domain, and I'll show you a workaround in another video soon. So we're just gonna click on publish to a Canva domain, continue. You can choose your name. I'm just gonna use Adrian Test Site. Continue. Here, you're able to describe your website in 160 characters or less. This can help with SEO and for people to actually find your site. You can enable password protection where people need a password to actually see it. And you can also hide it from search engines. And then you literally just click publish and it'll be ready to go. Once you click publish, you can add that link into your Instagram bio or your TikTok bio or really anywhere else that you need it. And that's all you do. The last thing I'll mention is if you want to see analytics, analytics of your site, how many clicks there were, traffic, things like that. Those features are available when you have a pro Canva subscription, but with the free version, you don't get access to that. But if you're making a simple landing page, you probably don't need that right now. And by the time you do, you may be ready to transfer your site over to a more advanced hosting site like Wix, which by the way is also free and so easy to use, but they just have a few more features and functions. Now, before you go, as I promised, I want to quickly just show you another way to do this. If you don't want to mess with a landscape format landing page and risk it not converting to mobile, you can just create a bio link site or a vertical website. So for this, I'm just going to search bio link. You'll notice if you search bio link website, mostly the landscape versions will show up, but if you search bio link, you'll see ones like this. You're just gonna click to open it as you would have before and proceed to go about customizing this the exact same way we did before. You can add pages, arrange things the way that you want. We're just gonna pretend that this is a different page too. And then the only difference with this whole thing is the way that you publish it. So you'll notice there's no publish button here at the top, but if you click on the share button and actually go down to website, if it's not popping up right here, click on more and you'll see it there. So you're gonna click on website. So if it's only one page, this doesn't matter, but if you have multiple pages, you wanna choose whether you want people to be able to swipe sideways, scroll up and down, have a navigation bar. So I'm gonna choose the scrolling effect and then I'm gonna click open website. This will allow me to actually preview what it looks like. So as you notice, the dimensions are still 9x16, even though I'm on a desktop. And if I were to be on a mobile device, it would show up like this. So that's why it's really great for bio link websites and things like that. Here is actually one that I am working on right now, my own little bio link website. And if I click on share and said website, open website, once your website pops up, you're actually just gonna take this exact URL and copy that, and that'll be the URL. So it's almost like this temporary preview of a page, but the buttons all still work the way they're supposed to. One little hack too is if you actually have the Bitly Chrome extension, or if you go to bit.ly, you can create a shorter link just so that it's not like super ugly in your bio. And I could say mobile site 24. I don't know. Then you would just copy that link, put it in your bio, and you're good to go. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to check out other website and business related videos I've created, check out the playlist, which I'll link right here, and subscribe if you haven't. See you in the next video. Bye.